Hello students, I am Manoj Kundare, the assistant professor of electronic science. Welcome back to our e-learning platform. In previous video, we have seen the details about the Nyquist theorem and the Shannon's theorem. The link of the previous video is available in the description box. Please check it. Now, in this video, we are going to see the details about the error handling codes in the communication. When the digital data is transmitted, bits flows from one point to the another point. We know that the digital data means the data which consists total ones and zeros in it is known as the digital data. And these ones and zeros are called as the bits of the data. During the transmission of this digital data, an error may occur at the receiver because of many interferences or noise. That is, 0 may changes to 1 or 1 may changes to 0. Let's see the effect of noise in this diagram. In this diagram, the computer first transmit a binary signal towards the computer second. At the computer first or at the transmitter, the binary signal is perfect in shape. But at the receiver or at the computer too, this binary signal gets distorted due to the effect of noise. That means the error gets introduced in the original information and the original information gets distorted. This error can degrade the accuracy of the digital system to a great extent. Therefore, it is necessary to detect and correct the errors. In this diagram, the effect of error or how the noise is introduced in the system is shown. Let's consider the transmitted data is 0101101001. According to this data, we can construct a square wave such as 0 means 0 level, 1 means 1 level, 0 means 0 level, 11 means 11 level, 00 means 00 level, 1 means 1 level. Okay, and during this transmission, the noise is get introduced into the system. This noise alters zeros into 1 and 1s into zeros. Here, consider the noise is introduced in the system. If we select a threshold value at a particular noise value, then according to this value, we can get the data as the signal is 0 and the noise level is below the threshold value, hence it represents 0. Similarly, here the data is 1, that means the signal is high and the noise level is above the threshold value, hence the data is 1. But consider at this point the original data is 0. This is the 0 level of the signal, but the noise level is above the threshold value. Hence, due to this noise, this 0 may convert into the 1. That means at this point, we get the received bit 1, but the original bit is 0. That is, 0 is converted into the 1 due to the effect of the noise. Hence, this noise can alters zeros into 1. That means it alters the quality of the signal. I hope you all understand how errors are introduced in the system. Now, let's see the necessity or need of error handling coding. In digital communication, errors are introduced during the transmission of the data from the transmitter to the receiver due to noise or some other reasons. In order to improve the reliability of the data transmission, error handling coding is necessary. To improve the reliability of the data transmission, the designer will have to increase the signal power or reduce the noise power. In order to improve the quality of the transmitted signal, the error handling coding is necessary. Now, let's see the types of error handling codes or error handling coding. Communication protocol contains some form of error checking methods. The main objective in the error detection is to ensure a fully correct transmission of a message. There are some methods of error checking such as Hamming codes, CRC, and checksum. Out of these three methods, the two methods, Hamming codes and CRC, are for the university exam. Let's see the description of each one by one. First of all, let's see the Hamming codes. The Hamming codes are error detecting and correcting codes. Hamming codes are linear block codes. Let's see the structure of Hamming codes. In Hamming code, the parity bits are added between the data bits. First of all, we have to know that what is meant by parity. It is very simple. Parity means the number of ones in the data. For example, consider the data 1111001. Okay, if this is the data, then we can calculate the number of ones such as 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. There are total 6th number of ones. Hence, this data is of even parity because the 6th number is of even number. Okay, I hope you all now understand what is meant by parity. Now let's see, the parity bits are inserted at each 2 raised to n, where n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. That is, the first bit is P1 is at 2 raised to 0, that means first position. The second bit is at 2 raised to 1, that is equal to 2, that means the second position. The third bit is at 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4, that means fourth position, hence it is named as the P4 bit. And the fourth bit is at 2 raised to 3. We know that 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8, that means the fourth bit is at the 8th position of the data. This is the D7, and if we increase the data size, the 8 size, then at this position we get the P8, that means 4th parity bit. To determine exactly where the error is, a sufficient number of bits must be added. The minimum number of Hamming bits is computed with the expression 2 raised to n greater than or equal to m plus n plus 1, where m is the number of bits in the data and n is the number of parity bits added. Let's see, we know the formula 2 raised to n is greater than or equal to n plus n plus 1. Suppose if we have the number of data bits 1, that means m is equal to 1, then we have to select the value of n such that it can satisfy this condition. Okay, for example, if we select n equal to 1, then we get the equation as 2 raised to 1 equal to, we know that m is equal to 1, n is equal to 1 plus 1. 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2, and 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. Hence, this condition is not satisfied. Hence, we cannot take n equal to 1. I hope you all understand the concept. Now let's see the value n equal to 2. We get to satisfy the equation 2 raised to n means 2 raised to 2 greater than or equal to m is equal to 1 plus n is equal to 2 plus 1. 2 raised to 2 equal to 4 greater than or equal to 1 plus 2 3, 3 plus 1 4. Hence, the condition is satisfied. Hence, we can take the n equal to 2. I hope you all understand how to calculate the parity bits. Let's see one more example here. If the number of data bits are 4, that means if m is equal to 4, then we have to select n number of parity bits. We have to satisfy this equation. This equation is 2 raised to n greater than or equal to m plus n plus 1. We have the value of m such that it has 4 plus, we have to select n equal to, suppose n equal to, put here 3. Okay, then we get m plus n equal to 3 plus 1, and here 2 raised to n means 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8 greater than or equal to 4 plus 3 plus 7 plus 8. Hence the condition gets satisfied. Hence we can put when m is equal to 4, n is equal to 3. As so on, we can calculate the number of parity bits or redundant bits. These calculations are given in the table. Okay, now let's see deciding the values of the parity bits. Following table indicates which bit positions are associated with each parity bit in order to establish required parity, even or odd, over the selected bit position. That means here is the data is given in which the parity bits are inserted. We know that P1, that means first parity bit, is at first position, second parity bit is at second position, third parity bit is at fourth position, fourth parity bit is at eighth position, and so on. Let's see, the parity bit first checks the positions first, third, fifth, seventh, 9, 11, 13, and 15. Similarly, P2 checks the position 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11, 14, 15, etc. P4 checks the position 4, 5, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14, 15. P8 checks the position 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. Now, let's see the example here. A bit word 1011 is to be transmitted. Construct the even parity 7-bit Hamming code for this data. First of all, we have to know that how many parity bits must be introduced. We know that we have the 4-bit data. That means we have m is equal to 4, and we have to calculate the number of the parity bits. We have the equation 2 raised to n is equal to m, 2 raised to n greater than or equal to m plus n plus 1. We have m is equal to 4. If we place n is equal to 2, then we get 2 raised to 2 plus n is equal to 2 plus 1. 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4 greater than or equal to 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 plus 7. Hence the condition is not satisfied here. Hence we cannot place the value of n as 2. We have to place the different values such that if consider the value of n is n equal to 3. We have the equation 2 raised to n is equal to m plus n plus 1. 2 raised to n means 2 raised to 3 plus m is equal to 4. N is equal to 3 plus 1. 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. Equal to 4 plus 3 is equal to 7 plus 8. Hence the condition is satisfied. That means 8 is greater than or is equal to 8. Hence the condition is satisfied. Hence we have to add the 3 parity bits. We know that the 3 parity bits can be added in this data, and the code word format becomes like this. Okay. The three parity bits are P1, P2 and P4 and the data is 1011 1011. Okay. Now our next step is decide P1. We have to calculate the P1. Okay. For the P1, we have to check the position 1357. 1357. Okay. As the data has D7, D5, D3, D7, D5, D3, 1, 1, 1. That means the data is 1, 1, 1 and there are total 3 number of 1s. It forms an odd parity. To make it even, we have to add another 1 here. Hence, put P1 is equal to 1 in order to have the even parity. That means we get the value of P1 as 1. Okay. Now the data becomes like that. The value of P1 is now 1. Similarly, we can calculate the P2. For P2, we have to check the positions 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. Okay. 2, 3, 6, 7 and as the data has D7, D6, D3, 1, 0, 1. There are total in this data, there are total 2 number of 1s. Hence, it has already even parity. Hence, there is no need to add 1 in this data. In this case, we can place the 0 here, hence put P2 is equal to 0 to get even parity. Okay, I hope you all understand the concepts here. Now let's see the value of P4. In this P4, we have to select or we have to check the positions 4, 5, 6, 7. We have to select the positions 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. But the D7, D6 and D5 is 1, 0, 1. Okay. 1, 0, 1s. That means there are total 2 number of 1s. Hence, we don't need to place extra 1 here. If we place the 1, then the total number of 1s becomes 3. And it gets the odd parity, but we have to construct the even parity. Hence, to get the even parity, we have to place here 0. Hence, the value of P4 is 0. I hope you all understand how to decide the parity bits. Okay, let's see the example for the homework. Encode the data bits 0101 into a 7-bit even parity Hamming code. Encode the data bits 0101 into a 7-bit odd parity Hamming code. This is the homework for you. Now, let's see the detection and correction of the errors by using Hamming codes. The Hamming coded data is transmitted. At the receiver, it is decoded to get the data back. For a 7-bit code, for even parity, the bits position 1357, 2367 and 4567 are checked for the even parity. If all 4 groups mentioned above have the even parity, then the received data include that the received code word is correct. But if the parity is not even, then it indicates that the error exists. Such an error can be located by forming the 3-bit number out of the 3 parity checks. Let's see this on the example. The example is that if the 7-bit received by a receiver is 1011001, assuming the even parity, state whether the received data is correct or wrong. If wrong, locate the bit error. Let's see the solution. the received data is put into the proper format, we get, if we place into proper format, then we get 1 0 1 1 0 1 1. Okay, here is, this is the first parity bit, second parity bit, and this is the third parity bit. Now let's see, analyze the bits 4 5 6 7 for P4. Okay, analyze the bits 4 5 6 7 for P4. Okay, we have the data P4 4 5 6 7 4 5 6 7. We get the data 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. It is of odd parity and we consider it for the even parity, hence the error exists here. Therefore put P4 is equal to 1 in its position of the error word. That means we have to the put P4 is equal to 1 at the position error bit. Okay, now sorry, the disturbance occur here. Okay, now let's see the step second. Analyze the data bits 2 3 6 7 for P2. The P2 checks the position 2 3 6 7. That means 2 3 6 and 7. Okay, at this position we get the data 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1. There are total 2 number of 1s, hence it has the even parity. Therefore the error does not exist here. The error does not exist, hence put P2 is equal to 0 in its position of the other word. We put the P4 is equal to 1 because the error exists at the P4 position, but at the P2 the error does not exist, hence we put P2 is equal to 0. Similarly we can calculate for the P1. Okay, for the P1, for P1 we have to check the positions 1 3 5 7, 1 3 5 and 7. At 1 3 5 7 we have data 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1. That means there are 3 number of 1s and 3 is the odd number, hence it has the odd parity, but we have to construct it for the even parity. That means the error exists here, hence if the error exists, then we have to place P1 is equal to 1 in its position of the error word. That means here the error exists, hence we have to put P1 is equal to 1 at the position of the P1. Now we get the error word as 101. Let's see how to calculate the error word or the positions in the error word. We get the error word 101, but we know that 101, that means binary 101, is equal to the decimal 5. Okay, that means the error is present at the fifth position of the data. Okay, that means the error is present at the fifth position, first, second, third, fourth, and this is the bit which contains the error. Okay, I hope you all now understand how to find the error bit. It is very simple. Whatever number occurred in the error word, this number position of the data contains the error. Okay, how to correct the error? It is very simple, that invert the incorrect bit to obtain the correct code as follows. We know that at the D5 position the error is occurred, hence we have to invert the position or the data is here such that the 0 is inverted as sorry the 1 is inverted into 0, that means we have to replace 1 by 0 and we get the correct data as 100 1011. Okay, I hope you all understand the procedure. Let's see the another example here. A 7 bit even parity Hamming code is received as 1110101. What is the correct code? Okay, the received code format is 1110101. Here is the first position is for P1, second position is for P2, and fourth position is for P4. Let's check bits for the P4. We have to check bits 4567. 4567. 4, 5, 6, and 7. We have the data 0111. That means there are total 3 number of ones. 3 is an odd number. We have to construct it for the even parity. Hence, the error exists here. For that purpose, due to this error, we have to place P4 is equal to 1 into the error word. That means at the position of the P4, we have to place 1. Okay. Similarly, we can check it for the parity bit P2. Okay. For P2, we have to check position 2367. 2, 3, 6, 7. At this position, we have data 0111. Again, it has the total 3 number of ones. Hence, it has the odd parity. Due to this odd parity, we get error here. Because of this error, put P2 is equal to 1. Okay, at the position of P2, put 1. Similarly, check the error for P1. For P1, we have to check the position 1357. 1357. We have data 1357. 1111. Okay, we have the data 1111. There are total 4 number of ones. We know that 4 is an even number. Hence, this has the even parity. And we have here even parity check. For due to this reason, there is no error. Hence, put P1 is equal to 0 at the position of the P1. We get the error word as P4, P2, P1, 110. Okay, we get the number as 110, but we know that 110 binary is equivalent to the decimal number 6. That means the error is present at the 6th position. How we calculate? Let's see once again. First of all, we get the error word as 110. This error word is in binary, and we know that the binary 110 is equal to the decimal 6. Okay, that means there is the error is at the 6th position. The 6th position has the bit 1. Now we have to correct this data. Hence, we have to simply invert this bit. 1 may inverted into the 0, or 1 may replaced by the 0, and we get the correct data. Okay. 1010101. I hope you all now understand how to calculate the error. Now let's see the next method of the error handling coding, that is CRC, cyclical redundancy check. Okay, the cyclical redundancy check, or CRC, is a mathematical technique used in synchronous data transmission that effectively catches 99.9% or more than transmission errors. The mathematical process implemented by the CRC is usually a division. Okay, CRC involves binary division of the data bits. The divisor is generated using the polynomials. Hence, the CRC is also called as the polynomial code checksum. Now, encoding using CRC format, the size of the message block and the CRC divisor is decided before the communication. That means before the communication started, the size of the message block is pre-decided. Okay. Suppose the block chosen may be CRC 74, where 7 is the total length of the block and 4 is the number of bits, and the 3 bits are the redundancy bits. The power of each term gives the position of bit and the coefficient gives the value of the bit. That means, for example, let's consider if the CRC generator is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 3 plus x plus 1. Then the corresponding binary pattern is obtained by 1 into x raised to 6 plus 1 into x raised to 5 plus 0 into x raised to 4 plus 1 into x raised to 3 plus 0 into x raised to 2 plus 1 into x raised to 1 and plus 1 into x raised to 0. That means if now we take the coefficient of this equation, we get the binary divisor as 1101011 1101011. Okay. Now the sender performs the binary division of the data segment by the divisor. It then appends the remainder or the CRC bits to the end of the data segments. This makes the resultant data unit divisible by the divisor, by the divisor. While decoding, the receiver divides the incoming data by the divisor. If there is no remainder, the data unit is assumed to be correct and accepted. Otherwise, it is understood that the data is corrupted and is therefore rejected. Okay. Now let's see this procedure on the example. Let's see the example here. The original message is 101000. Okay. We have the polynomial x raised to 3 plus 1. If we place the coefficient of this equation, we get 1 into x raised to 3 plus 0 into x raised to 2 plus 0 into x raised to 1 plus 1 into x raised to 0. And according to this equation, we get the divisor as we take only the coefficient 1001001. This is our 4-bit polynomial divisor. Okay. Now let's see, if the CRC generator is of n bit, then append n minus 1 zeros in the end of the original message. That means the CRC generator is 1001. That means it has the total 4 bits. Then we have to append n minus 1 bits. That means 4 minus 1 bits, total 3 zeros at the end of the original message. Hence, here is the 3 zeros are added at the end of the message. Now we have to perform here an XOR operation or the division operation. During this division, whatever the remainder is, this remainder is connected or appended at the last positions. We get the data, the correct data here. This is the process done at the transmitter. Similarly, at the receiver, the similar process is done. That means the whatever data is transmitted is divided by the divisor. Okay. And after the division, if we get the zero remainder, then there is no error exists. Hence, the data is correct and it gets accepted. I hope you all understand the process of the CRC method. Okay. Now, for example, let's see the operation here in detail. First of all, we have the question as 1 and we have to perform XOR operation with 1010 and 1011. Sorry, 1001. We know that the 0 XOR 1 we get 1, 1 XOR 0 we get 1, 0 XOR 0 we get 0, 1 XOR 1 we get 0. Okay, that means in this case we get the remainder 1 1, then we place 0 here, hence we get 0. Another 0 we get quotient as 0, and now we perform the XOR operation again here 1010. Okay, we get 0 XOR with 1 we get 1, 0 XOR with 0 we get 0, 1 XOR with 0 we get 1, 1 XOR with 1 we get 0. Okay, now the next 0 is taken, the data becomes 1010. Now the XOR operation again performed 1001. Okay, now here we get 0 XOR with 1 we get 1, 1 XOR with 0 we get 1, 0 XOR with 0 we get 0, 1 XOR with 1 we get 0. Okay, by this process the XOR operation or the division operation is performed, and whatever the remainder is, this remainder is appended or joined to the original message. Okay, this original message is now transmitted, and at the receiver this message is again divided, or the XOR operation is again performed by the predetermined the divisor. And during this division, if we get the remainder 0, then it is considered that the data is correct and it can be accepted. I hope you all understand the Hamming code and the CRC method. Thank you.